For North Carolina, forward a 6'8 senior from East Meadow, New York, number 44, Matt Doherty. For Duke at forward, a 6'8 sophomore from Scottsdale, Arizona, number 32, Mark Allery. For North Carolina at forward, a 6'9 senior from Latham, New York, number 41, Sam Perkins. For Duke, a forward, a 6'7 junior from St. Catharines, Ontario, number 45, Dan Mahar. For North Carolina at center, a 6'10 freshman from Kohler, Wisconsin, number 24, Joe Wolf. For Duke at center, a 6'8 sophomore from Rolling Hills Estate, California, number 21, Jay Billis. North Carolina guard, a 6'2½ freshman from Queens, New York, number 30, Kenny Smith. For Duke at guard, a 6-foot freshman from Falls Church, Virginia, number 4, Tommy Amaker. For North Carolina at guard, a 6'6 junior from Wilmington, North Carolina, number 23, Micheal Jordan. For Duke at guard, a 6'2 sophomore from Washington, D.C., number 24, Johnny Dawkins. Dean Smith is the coach of the Tar Heels. Mike Krzyzewski for the Duke Blue Devils.
Mark Allery with the first possession of the basketball game. And this is Tommy Amaker, who hit that shot in overtime yesterday. He called it a dream come true to win a game like that with a jumper. Allery to Dawkins through his hands and out of bounds. Tried the alley open, it didn't work.
Johnny Dawkins is such a great leaper inside. The Duke uses that play frequently. He got by Kenny Smith, but it was a bad pass.
Smith being guarded by Amaker. This is Sam Perkins. And watch Carolina run its offense. They do it as well as anybody in the country. Matt Doherty, who had 22 yesterday, penetrates, no good, foul block against Duke. Doherty, I think, really surprised people yesterday. He is the role player on this team. Does not score much, but he buried him yesterday with 22 points.
Played a very aggressive offensive game. You get a look, North Carolina leads the series, leads 5-4 in ACC tournament play.
First foul is on Jay Billis. That's number one on Billis. Number one on Duke as a team. And Doherty's free throw shot is good. He is a 77% free throw shooter as a team. North Carolina is number two in the nation at 79%. Missed this one, however, and Billis has the rebound.
Duke's going to try to run where they can to get up the court and get some easy opportunities against North Carolina, particularly against the trapping defense, which Carolina is in now.
Dawkins doing what he does best, going inside. Billis offensive rebound, and Jay Billis, the sophomore out of Rolling Hills, California, puts Duke ahead 2-1. Smith, this is Wolf. Of course, Brad Doherty not starting because of that hand injury. Wolf, jump hook with the left hand, won't go.
Jay Billis tipped that in.
Billis got a fingertip up on it, and unfortunately for him and the Blue Devils, the ball went right into the hoop.
Carolina changes defense. They're in a 1-3-1 zone now. It looks like they'll trap when they get an opportunity in the corners or over on the sideline.
This is Dan Mahar out of St. Catharines, Ontario. Inside to Billis. Lost the handle. Got it back to Amaker. And that diagonal pass. Here's another one. And Mahar didn't go for it. I think he thought it was for someone else.
I think he thought the pass was to Jay Billis. And based on where it was thrown, that would have been my guess, too. Billis was setting a screen for Mahar, though.
Carolina leading it 3-2. This is Perkins, or Jordan, rather.
Now Duke's in the man-to-man defense. They're noted for the tough physical man-to-man that they play. Watch the Johnny Dawkins, Micheal Jordan matchup.
Doherty with Allery on him. His jumper is good. 3 points for Matt Doherty, and what a change this is with North Carolina looking to get Doherty the basketball.
Brad Doherty out of the game. That changes some roles out there. They've got to get some more offense from somebody.
It's 5-2. Air ball from Amaker. Kenny Smith ahead to Jordan. Jordan had the pass knocked out of bounds by Amaker. How many times this year have we seen Amaker do just that on a fast break?
Amaker did an excellent job getting back on defense. He took a tough shot on offense. He's matched up against Micheal Jordan when he's on offense. That's too tough a shot.
Wolf on the alley-oop inside and almost tipped in by Allery.
Duke certainly doesn't want to give Carolina any help. I don't think the Tar Heels really need it.
Mahar, low to Allery, who had the big game yesterday, especially in the second half. He's double-teamed right now, and he'll bring it out himself. This is Tommy Amaker.
Boy, that's some aggressive defense by North Carolina. They drop now into the man-to-man.
Let's see if they can get it to Allery. They have him in the corner this time. Cross-court to Mahar, guarded by Dory. Damn Mahar, who does not shoot the ball very often, put that one down.
In fact, the last couple of weeks, he's been passing up a lot of opportunities. If he can hit that shot, it's going to put a lot of pressure on the Carolina defense.
Micheal Jordan to Dory on the backcourt cut. He beat Mahar. Can Micheal Jordan do it all or what?
That's a play that North Carolina runs so well, that backdoor play. Excellent pass inside.
Doherty with 5 of Carolina's 7 points. This is Billis. Dawkins left all alone for the jumper, and Johnny Dawkins puts it down. He has 2 in this ballgame.
Good ball movement by the Duke Blue Devils. Mark Allery thus far not very involved in the offense. Good defense.
Doherty cross court. Wolf pulls up. Offensive foul.
Good defense by the Duke Blue Devils. They recognized that North Carolina was in trouble in the corner. They came to double team. Dawkins does a nice job with the double team. Then he crosses all the way over the lane, gets the charge call against Wolf. Nice play by Johnny Dawkins.
David Henderson checks into the ballgame for the Blue Devils. Brad Doherty coming in for North Carolina, and Wolf will sit down. Steve Hale also checks into the ballgame for the Tar Heels. He's a 6'3 sophomore out of Jenks, Oklahoma. There you see it, and it's been that way almost all year long. Duke near the top of the ACC in scoring, at the bottom in giving up points. Henderson played a big role in yesterday's win over Georgia Tech. And Amaker left alone. Mason Hall.
Nice play by David Henderson. He knew the double team was coming. He waited for Tommy Amaker to get back through the lane. Since Smith had set the double team, Amaker was wide open.
Duke regains the lead. They try to get the ball inside to Perkins, but Dawkins with a steal to Amaker. Allery. Big shot by Mark Allery, and Duke on top, 10-7 in the early going.
Over the last couple of weeks of the season, that's the shot that Allery's been getting and hitting consistently. And when he hits that, he is awfully tough.
Hale to Kenny Smith. It's been an up-tempo game so far. Hale lost the ball. Amaker knocked it away, but Amaker called for the personal foul. Number 1 on Tommy Amaker, the second team foul called against the Blue Devils. And Mike Krzyzewski voices his opinion on the sideline. There's a look at Dean Smith.
It's a game that concerns Dean Smith simply because it's obvious that these two teams match up against one another rather well. Duke has the good guards who can get in and out of those double teams. They've got the good shooters who can take advantage of the opportunities that they'll get.
Hale, an 86% shooter from the free throw line. His dad used to be the coach at Oral Roberts, so he grew up understanding basketball. Hits this one. 2 for Hale, and it's Duke by 1 with 15:41 to go. First half of play. Duke 10, North Carolina 9. Back after this. Minutes, 41 seconds to go, first half. Duke on top of North Carolina, 10-9, and here is the full court pressure. Henderson beats it with a dribble. Duke with the advantage. Dawkins inside, blocked by Perkins. Hale with a loose ball. Ahead to Matt Doherty. Collision in the backcourt, no whistle. Doherty missed the layup. Jordan with a jam follow. This may go on all afternoon.
This looks like a continuation of that great game that these two teams played last weekend. Great offensive and defensive basketball by both teams.
Amaker to Dawkins.
North Carolina in the man-to-man. It's an aggressive man-to-man, and they'll trap when they get the opportunity.
Henderson, good shooter out of the perimeter, and nails it from the corner. Duke regains the lead at 12-11 on Henderson's first bucket.
Like in that first game, there were 26 ties and 15 lead changes. That's another lead change today.
Did you see the contact? That's 3 possessions out of the last 4 where there has been a lot of contact. contact and no whistle. The officials are telling the players, hey guys, this game is yours.
Micheal Jordan sort of holding his hip as he came down the court. We'll have to see if maybe he hurt himself.
Henderson trying to penetrate, has to dish it off. Saved by Dawkins. 14-23 to go. It's Carolina by one.
Good help by Sam Perkins. He forced that dish back outside.
Mahar, the backdoor pass to Dawkins. Lost it. Got it back to Amaker. Won't go. What a rebound by Perkins.
Excellent inside defense by North Carolina.
This is Hale. Brad Doherty. Seems to be handling the ball very well, and he backs in on Mahar, and they will call Brad Doherty for the offensive foul.
And that was a good call. Dean Smith's up claiming that Mahar pulled him back in, but that wasn't the case there. Micheal Jordan, what an athlete he is. Penetrates around the baseline. Even though he's fallen down, you can see his concentration. He kept looking the ball into the basket. What a play.
He's a better shooter prone than most people are standing straight up. Carolina by one, 13-12, Duke's basketball.
Now North Carolina showing a 2-3 zone. We'll have to see if they stay in it.
Mahar comes out high. Far corner, Henderson. Won't go for him. Kenny Smith in the middle for the rebound.
North Carolina dropped back on the first pass into a 1-3-1 zone. Duke took the long shot.
Doherty inside. Matt Doherty missed the shot. Here comes Dawkins. It's a 2-on-4 fast break, and Dawkins almost lost it. Got it back. Duke trying to settle down the tempo a little bit. 13 minutes, 19 seconds to go in a half.
North Carolina back to the man-to-man.
Dawkins guarded by Hale, tries to go inside to Allery, held by Brad Doherty. That's his second.
Great job by Mark Allery getting position. He had Brad Doherty pinned on his back, and then when the ball went to Allery's side, boom, he got him right there, got big inside. Doherty tried to come through him, and that's two fouls on Brad Doherty.
And you see Dean Smith up, he's getting Wolf back into the ball game and takes Doherty out. He picks up two.
Picture perfect. Mark Allery goes right to him, turns around, gets him on his back. That was a great play by Allery.
13-12, Carolina by one, and boy, these teams played such outstanding games during the regular season.
You got a shot there of Micheal Jordan coming in the ball game. He looks a little serious. All five Duke starters have a basket, plus David Henderson, the sixth man coming in off the bench, has a basket, so Duke's moving it around.
Something you need to do against Carolina also. Although in those the last ball game they played, Dawkins and Allery combined for 53 points. Mahar, nice pass underneath for Allery.
Play by the Duke Blue Devils. Micheal Jordan went for the steal that created an opening, and Duke found it.
Perkins has the ball stripped. Kenny Smith comes down with it, and he puts it home. Kenny Smith puts Carolina back on top, 15-14.
I wonder how long these teams can go at one another like this.
No, they did it the game.
Well, they did it for 50 minutes in Chapel Hill.
Amaker got rid of Smith. Jump shot short. Perkins rebound. Perkins already the number one all-time rebounder, the number two scorer. Backcourt violation, it's, oh! Sam Perkins made one of the great plays that'll never show up on the stat sheet that you'll ever see. If he touched the ball, Carolina would have lost it, so he waited for Duke to come over and get near it and knocked it off him.
Mike, I think he thought that was the case, but Tommy Amaker had actually knocked the ball into the backcourt. That's why Amaker was going after it so hard. Sam nearly made a big mistake in not picking it up.
But from his standpoint, it was a brilliant play.
If it works, it's fine.
There's a bad pass going whistling by Jordan out of bounds. Wolf turns it over.
Jordan was just going the wrong direction and didn't have time to recover and get over there. Mahar's coming out of the ball game. Billis is back in.
Carolina by one. This is Henderson. He's being guarded by Jordan. Amaker picked up by Kenny Smith. You see the tape on the left hand of Smith. Had that broken wrist, missed several games. Amaker, Dawkins, past Hale, penetrating, shot through the foul. Well, I think even Johnny Dawkins would have laughed if he'd have made that one. He wanted the foul, and he got that.
That was a real tough shot, but once again, North Carolina came with the double-team pressure, and when they did, Duke started moving the ball, and so Dawkins ended up with that opening. Carolina got over there well. Hale committed the foul.
Number one on Steve Hale. It's the fourth team foul called against Carolina. And Dawkins at the free throw line, where he is deadly.
Duke moves the basketball so well that they shoot many more free throws than their opponents, and it's because with their ball movement, they put their opponents in tough spots.
Dawkins has tied it at 15. And has his club ahead. 11:47 to go in the first half. We have a timeout on the court. Our score, the Blue Devils at Duke, 16. North Carolina, 15.
And off the mark offensively for North Carolina. Carolina 6 of 10, but Perkins has not scored in the game.
Hale covered by Dawkins, and Dawkins stole a bounce pass. Has three players in front of him, gets it to Henderson down the lane, and Johnny Dawkins may have gotten away with not giving up the basketball.
I think it was good recognition by Johnny Dawkins. He saw some guys coming that his teammates couldn't see, and what a steal by him.
Amaker took it away from dribble. Tough break for Tommy Amaker, who just picked Kenny Smith's pocket.
As Amaker comes out of the steal, you can see it here. He's going to lose control of the ball. Now he's got control there. He bounces it now. It goes up over his head. That's a good call. He did carry the ball, and that was the call.
Could have been a big possession there. Duke already leading 18 to 15 with 11:05 to go. And six turnovers against Carolina.
Duke has shown the ability to force Carolina.
Micheal Jordan got the rebound, put in his third field goal. He has 6 points. Most people's idea of the player of the year in college basketball.
Well, I certainly think so. He doesn't get too many shots blocked, but he did a nice job staying after the ball.
Mallory can't penetrate, back out to Dawkins.
Carolina back in that 1-3-1 zone. Micheal Jordan is so active.
Nice pass inside, the miss slam by Jay Billis. And then he commits the personal foul on the follow. Jay Billis has to be a little bit sick that one wouldn't go for him.
Good pressure defensively by Joe Wolf is what causes Billis to miss this slam. Maybe that hack across the wrist helped. Then Billis fouled coming up from the back. Mike Krzyzewski is really not pleased right at the moment.
Neither of the Duke fans. This is Jordan. Won't go. Tipped by Wolf. It's good.
Sam Perkins kept it alive, and then Wolf was able to tip it in. Nice job by Big Sam.
Carolina scores four straight to take a 19-18 lead. Henderson had the shot. Now Perkins comes out of him again. Henderson will not normally pass that shot up. Right backdoor pass to Johnny Dawkins. Henderson really showed patience on that.
And his teammates cut and gave him somebody to pass to.
Dawkins with six, and Duke with a one-point lead. Pass will go past Micheal Jordan, out of bounds. Wolf tried to throw him the bounce pass, and it was a little wide.
Just a great matchup going on right now between David Henderson and Micheal Jordan. Really battling on both ends of the court.
And Henderson is a whale of an athlete. He can play.
Carolina once again changes up the defense. It's man-to-man now.
Dawkins to Amaker, now to Henderson, penetrating. Looking for someone, finds Allery. Duke is moving the ball exceptionally well today. You've got to do it against Carolina. Billis playing with two fouls. Dawkins. Did you see that? Johnny Dawkins went on that jump. He has 8 points, and it's Duke by three.
Sam Perkins has Allery on his back.
Not anymore.
Good recognition by Micheal Jordan. Perkins positioned himself perfectly, and then when the ball went across the court, Sam was calling for it. Here you go, Johnny Dawkins coming in. Question there is he ever going to come down? Nice shot.
This ACC game is being brought to you in part by Mazda, by Holly Farms, and by Bost Bakeries. 8:47 to go. This is Billis. Duke on top.
Great step by Mark Alley, and once again, Duke breaks that double team, gets an easy shot.
6 points for Mark Alley, and it's Duke by three at 24-21. Matt Doherty, low to Jordan, and Jordan scores over Alley after he got away from Henderson, and that's eight for Micheal Jordan.
Jordan doing a tremendous job working for position inside against Henderson. We've said all year Micheal Jordan may bite his tongue eventually. He may have done it. He's feeling up at his mouth like something happened.
Billis got Allery in the lane. A lot of contact, and they'll call a travel, no foul. Sports for Jay Billis. That may have been a break that it wasn't called against him because he already has two personal. Of course, he thought the foul should have gone against Matt Doherty.
That's really a tough call by the official. With all that contact there, it seems sometimes like that contact is what causes the walk. So maybe the foul should be called instead of the walk.
It's Duke, 24. Carolina, 23. This is Steve Hale handling the ball. He and Kenny Smith at the guards right now. Micheal Jordan will get a breather. Sam Perkins back out to Smith. Sensational freshman. Hale with a nice fake gets free at the baseline, and Steve Hale puts it away for his first two. Carolina back on top by one.
Duke showed a zone for the first time in the game. Carolina recognized, was good and patient.
Amaker. 10-footer, and Tommy Amaker puts it down. Great shooting by both of these ball clubs. Doherty trying to beat the pack into the lane, lost the ball, but called Amaker for the foul.
That's Tommy Amaker's second personal foul, and that might be a big call because Amaker is vitally important in Duke's ability to break the North Carolina pressure.
7 minutes, 18 seconds to go. First half of play. It's Duke 26, North Carolina 25. Back in Greensboro after this. They have been neck and neck since the start of the ball game, and look at the shooting percentages.
And that's two pretty good defensive teams out there as well.
That's so for sure.
This is an outstanding shooting performance by both clubs.
They are both playing about as well as they can play right now. Into the ball game for Duke is Doug McNeely, the senior who played quite a bit yesterday, and he gets his first rebound.
Great blockouts by both Billis and McNeely. They moved Perkins and Wolf right out of there. Duke was in the 2-3 zone on the out-of-bounds play.
Allery is getting a breather right now. This is Billis in the lane, and he scores. And we have seen contact like this the entire game with no whistles as Perkins went down. The officials really letting them play the game.
Sam Perkins has spent a lot of time on his backside in this game. Duke stays in the zone.
28-25. Hale. And both of these teams are very adept at drawing charges. And they're not getting many of those today.
Good active zone by Duke. Gee, Doug McNeely hanging on to Joe Wolf. He's lucky to get through the lane.
This is Wolf to Kenny Smith. Missed the shot, and the loose ball goes to Billis.
Great block out again by McNeely.
Ahead to Mohawk. And one of the few times you will see Carolina go a little sleepy on defense.
I think Sam Perkins just fell asleep. Mahar beat him down the court. Good hustle by Mahar.
It's Duke by five. Matt Doherty. Won't go for him. Wolf with a tip, and we've got a foul underneath. I think it's on Dan Mahar.
What a battle going on underneath. Joe Wolf, yeah. Sam Perkins just pounding Jay Billis, Dan Mahar back and forth. That time Joe Wolf got the measure of Mahar.
And Micheal Jordan checks back in the ball game. Kenny Smith will go out. Allery will come back in for the Blue Devils. There's Jordan. Foul on Mahar was his first.
It's important that guys like McNeely and Henderson can come in the game to give the Duke players a blow because they really haven't had much rest and they played a tough game yesterday.
And it also helps spread out their foul difficulties. Alley-oop to Perkins. Lost it, and we've got the foul.
And I think the foul's on Jay Billis.
And if it is, it is number three on Jay Billis.
Now they got Doug McNeely. Here's Sam Perkins in position for the lob. Tough pass. McNeely, you can see very clearly, reaches in and gets him across the arm. That alley-oop is such a difficult play to execute. You see it all the time, and I think the reason it looks so easy is because of the abilities of the athletes executing it. That was just a tough pass. Perkins did well to even catch it.
His last 20 games, Sam Perkins has averaged more than 19 points a contest and is the number 9 scorer in ACC history. And you might, if you have your home videotape rolling, you might save that one. He doesn't miss many.
He's a tremendous free throw shooter.
He's a tremendous everything.
He sure is.
Perkins, all that concentration, hits this one. It's now 30-26. Duke on top by four. Full court pressure.
This is zone pressure until Duke's going to get it across half court. Dawkins does that well.
McNeely fouled by Sam Perkins, and McNeely took it right to the big guy.
If you've got guys like Dawkins and Amaker who can handle the ball, you can really put some pressure on a defense. Dawkins doing a great job getting it down the court. McNeely taking it right to Sam Perkins, who did foul.
And he made sure he protected the ball with his arms and his body so that if Perkins was going to get a piece of it, he was also going to get a piece of the 6'5 senior out of El Paso, Texas. Free throw's good.
And McNeely has given the Blue Devils a boost. He looks real sharp today.
Only a 57% free throw shooter on the year, but that first one was perfect. And it's 31-26. This one's short, but he got the roll. McNeely with two free throws, 2 points on the afternoon. It's 32-26. Jordan Dawkins got back in a hurry to cut him off at the pass.
Carolina just keeps the pressure on. Those free throws went in, and North Carolina right away back to the attack.
Jordan turned around, put it up with the left hand, missed the shot, foul against Carolina, and I think it's Perkins.
It is Sam Perkins. Micheal Jordan put that shot up with the left hand, might have made the shot a little bit more difficult than it needed to be. You can see Jordan is loose down inside, but that left-handed shot is just a little bit off. Perkins comes clearly over the back of Jay Billis. That's two fouls on Sam Perkins.
And Dean Smith will get him out of the game with 5:18 left and put big Brad Doherty back in there.
Brad Doherty as well has two fouls. And Doherty got fast. He wasn't in very long.
Got him in about 3 minutes. Duke in control right now, 32-26.
Carolina playing the zone.
Allery won't go. Rebound of Brad Doherty. Seems to be playing fine with that bandage on his right hand.
Seems to be catching the ball well. That's going to be the important thing for Doherty.
Matt Doherty, who proved yesterday you can't leave him alone, to Hale. Hale missed. Billis with another rebound. Boy, Billis is doing a job.
He really got up there. Great, strong rebound by Jay Billis.
Allery has it. Yesterday, and his teammates looked for him and hit him with the pass. This time they did it again, and Joe Wolf fouled him.
One of the most dangerous things about the Duke Blue Devils is how well their big guys run the court. You can see Allery there calling for the ball, and what an athletic move. That guy can really get up and down.
Allery already with 8 points, and this is David Popson, the freshman from Ashley, Pennsylvania, who comes in because Wolf has two personal fouls. But Carolina can go to that bench, and it never seems to end. Allery, who has just enjoyed an incredible season, missed the free throw, had a chance for the three-point play, but it's still Duke by eight at 34-26. And Carolina is not playing poorly.
Duke stays in the 2-3 zone. This has worked well for them. They've went to their spurt out of this defense.
This is Hale.
It's a good aggressive zone.
Doherty gets off the 15-footer, won't go. Billis with another rebound.
Billis has just run a tower of strength on those boards.
He has been saying to North Carolina, these are mine, and he's taken them. Allery again, double team, bad bounce pass.
Good defense by North Carolina. Allery knew he was in there about 3 seconds and had to get rid of it.
4-2, Jordan, the basket will count.
And that's three fouls against Tommy Amaker.
Amaker reached in, and 10 points for Jordan.
Amaker guessed wrong. Steve Hale made him think he was going to pass it to the other side to Popson and then went back to Jordan. Amaker was out of position. Jordan has the opportunity for a three-point play, and this will be a big one.
Amaker looks up at the scoreboard to see what they're saying about his personal foul situation, and the scoreboard tells him he has three. There's Matt Doherty, who has gone to the bench for a breather.
It's a good thing we're not looking at Mike Krzyzewski. He was telling Joe Forte what he thought of that foul.
Jordan trying for the three-point play, and he misses a free throw. Very rare for Micheal Jordan. Margin is 6, 34-28 with 3:50 to go in the half.
North Carolina has not been a 79% free throw shooting team, and that's one of the reasons why they're behind in this half.
Dawkins working on Hale to Amaker. Guarded by Kenny Smith. Nice pass inside to Billis, double team. Stripped to the ball by Jordan, and here comes Hale. Kenny Smith! What you have to do to get an offensive a foul, you have to bury somebody.
And what a break for the Duke Blue Devils. I really thought that they could have caught Mark Allery. Watch Allery to the left of your screen. He's going to reach that arm in right there. Oh. They didn't call the foul against him, but Smith did run into McNeely.
What a collision. 3:30 to go in the half. Duke 34, Carolina 28. Don't go away. Allery reached, well, he got the arm back, it looked like.
He got the arm back, but he got it in there, and most of the time a foul's called by what it looks like. I think the two teams just got down the court so quickly, maybe the official was not in the position to see that particular play, but he could sure see the charge.
Then again, they haven't called too many touch fouls today. The Blue Devils against Carolina have done a tremendous job at forcing North Carolina into turnovers. They've averaged 18-5 against them. They have 8 so far today.
North Carolina averages only about 10 turnovers a game, so Duke really does a nice job against them.
We've been telling you what a great job Jay Billis has been doing. He already has 7 rebounds in less than 17 minutes of the first half, and he's been playing against Perkins and Doherty. Here's the alley-oop, loose ball. Billis comes down with it into the lane.
It's working. That ball was a bad alley-oop pass that went right to Jay Billis, and he knocked in a tough shot.
It's an 8-point spread for the Blue Devils, who are 36-28 over North Carolina.
Duke stays in the 2-3 zone, and North Carolina not doing very much movement against the zone defense. Johnny Dawkins kicked that one.
And they'll reset the 45-second shot clock. Matt Doherty comes back in. Kenny Smith comes out, so Hale will run the offense.
Dean Smith's substitutions this afternoon, a little bit different from what he normally does. Normally, he runs people in and out to give his players a breather, and that may be what he's doing today, but it really looks like he's struggling to find a combination that can solve this Duke team.
Both teams have shot exceptionally well in the first half. It's just been a tremendously well-played ball game. Kenny Smith to Matt Dart.
Duke players out there talking with one another. You can hear them yelling back and forth. Great defense in that zone.
Matt Doherty, and they'll drop off a hit. They'll force him to shoot that jumper. Jordan won't go. Kenny Smith with a long rebound. Tries to penetrate. Grant Doherty.
Nice move by Kenny Smith. That time, Doug McNeely, even though he had Doherty blocked out, McNeely's only 6'5", Doherty 6'11". He used that height advantage to tip it back.
First 2 points for Brad Doherty. It's 36-30 with 2:03 to go. First half of play. Henderson, Dawkins.
Carolina back in the 1-3-1 zone.
Great pass to Allery from McNeely. And Allery took that pass and in one motion caught it and went up for the basket. He has 10.
Great catch and move by Allery.
Ooh, Jordan. Oh, what a quick first step up to Matt Doherty. Couldn't maintain possession. Wolf knocked away by Henderson, who dives out of bounds after McNeely.
McNeely came into the picture just like a white flash going by there. His white uniform flashed by. He nearly had that ball.
Look at the shooting. Duke shooting 68%. Carolina shooting 50. And the Blue Devils have hit 9 of their last 10 shots. Alley-oop to Jordan. What a catch.
Again, he went up with that left-handed shot and couldn't get the roll into the basket.
The play was making the catch in the first place. Billis loses it on the turnover. Here comes Carolina. And then Doherty has it taken away by McNeely and hit to Billis. Holy cow, it's Carolina down by 10, and the Blue Devils are tearing it up.
And this place is going crazy.
Smith to Matt Doherty. This is Jordan, short. Jordan with a loose ball. He is everywhere. 51 seconds to go in the half. Duke by 10. Brad Doherty, and he puts it down.
Nice shot by Brad Doherty. He was right in the middle of a crowd of Duke players. He kept the ball up above his head the whole time, turned and dropped it in the basket.
40-32. Let's see if the Blue Devils play for one shot. Carolina trying to force the tempo with that defense. 30 seconds left. Dawkins says, one shot, let's do it. This is Allery, who comes out high. Duke wanting to go in with at least an 8-point lead at the break. Oh, Neely, McNeely was wide open. He goes into the lane for the jumper. It won't go. And here's a loose ball picked up by Allery. outside. 7 seconds left. Henderson missed the shot. Brad Doherty with a rebound. Ahead to Kenny Smith. 1 second left. He got it off in time, but it didn't go.
I'll tell you what, Mike, what a first half of action. Just end to end in the last couple of minutes. This is everything that we thought it might be. On the boards, but they're doing a nice job staying right with him. You see Allery with 8, Dawkins and Bill. Allery with 10, Dawkins and Billis both with 8. Jordan leading the way for Carolina with 10.
And nobody else with more than 5 for North Carolina.
Now Duke opens in a man-to-man, and Carolina goes right to Sam Perkins and knocks it down.
Perkins cuts the lead to 6 at 40-34. This is game number 1 of our semifinal afternoon.
And you can look to see North Carolina turn up the heat a little more this half.
Amaker, low to Billis. Back to Tommy Amaker, who's playing with 3 personal fouls. Dawkins inside to Allery. Triple team, and he scored anyway.
He did a great job even getting that ball up. Micheal Jordan dropped down inside and had him.
Mark Allery has a dozen, and it's Duke 42, Carolina 34. Kenny Smith with the ball to Matt Doherty. Inside to Perkins, who got away from Allery. Perkins gets position as well as anybody who plays this game.
It's a good move by Carolina, not only to get Sam Perkins involved in the offense, but to put some pressure defensively on Mark Allery. And that time, Dawkins, excellent pass, but Mahar just didn't catch it.
It was a great pass because Dawkins saw the double team coming, and it's just before it got to him, he whipped the pass, but off the hand of Dan Mahar. Duke 42, North Carolina 36. This is Micheal Jordan by Mahar with a great move. He finally got one in with a left hand.
I think Mahar thought he had Jordan trapped down there on the baseline, and that's a bad assumption to make with Micheal Jordan. Nice spin move.
That's a dozen for Micheal Jordan, and the halftime lead of 8 is cut to 4.
It's a big possession for Duke. They'd really like to score and keep Carolina from making a run.
Johnny Dawkins trying to penetrate, had the ball blocked by Doherty. Loose ball, Doherty comes up with it. It's a 3-on-3 break. Doherty holds up for the jumper and buries it. And North Carolina is within 2.
They're not the number 1 team in the country because their uniforms look nice. They can really come back.
Mike Krzyzewski up off the bench calling out a play. Amaker, baseline all the way for Amaker. It won't go, but it's a blocking foul, I believe.
Brad Doherty just hasn't had any luck in terms of the foul calls today. Tough move by Amaker. This is a big play. Amaker trying to penetrate inside. See, Doherty reacts very quickly, but Amaker had already left his feet by the time Doherty got set. Excellent call.
And that is 3 fouls on Brad Doherty. Amaker must have held his breath. It could have been his 4th if Doherty had gotten there a little earlier. Amaker at the free throw line, an 83% shooter. Has 4 points on the afternoon. Got the first one.
North Carolina can put such withering pressure on a team, and one of these runs, it's very important for Duke to score a couple of baskets to break the momentum and get back into the type of game that they were playing in the first half.
Amaker very patient at the free throw line. Freshman out of Falls Church, Virginia. Makes them both, and it's 44-40, stopping that North Carolina run. Kenny Smith and Jordan are the guards. Matt Doherty, Brad Doherty, and Sam Perkins up front.
Duke shows us that zone once again.
Amaker went for the steal, didn't get it. Jordan in the middle of the zone. No good. Billis with a rebound. That is number 8 for Jay Billis, who is doing yeoman work inside.
They're going to nickname him the broom of somebody for the way he's sweeping the ball off those boards. He's having a great game.
Amaker got a nice screen from Billis, but Carolina did a brilliant job on switching men. Ball knocked away. Stolen. Here comes Jordan. Right side. And there is nothing wrong with that right hand, although he's shaking it a little bit after that jam.
Excellent play. Doherty knocked the ball away. Micheal Jordan picked it up, and it was a very controlled type fast break. Jordan just waited for the opening.
At 6 for Doherty, the lead again cut to 2. It's Duke 44. North Carolina 42 with 17:03 to go in the ballgame. Carolina really intensifying the defensive pressure. Amaker.
And Duke doing a nice job to try to be a little bit more patient.
Allery tries to get out of the lane, dumps it off the bench. This time the jumper won't go, and Brad Doherty with a rebound. We have had a lot of contact the entire game, but you have to credit the officials. They have let these kids play basketball. Brad Doherty to Smith, now Matt Doherty. Carolina with a chance to tie here. Jordan has to get rid of it to Smith.
And boy, have they looked sharp doing it. Michael Jordan with a tremendous pass once he got up in the air, and Kenny Smith just buried it.
12-4 scoring run for Carolina.
Carolina now goes back to the zone.
Dawkins from outside. It won't go, but the tip to Phillips, the offensive rebound to Phillips. Couldn't get the shot in, but he gets the foul, and it's going to be on Kenny Smith.
And Kenny Smith is disgusted. He's over there holding his eye. I think Jay Billis got him with an elbow as he was going up, but Billis got that first tip. That didn't go. He stayed right after it. This is a long shot by Dawkins against the zone. You can see Billis down in the bottom of your screen. They're getting great position. One tip takes it up very strongly. Kenny Smith got called for the foul. He's holding his eye. Here you see another view of it. Great position inside by both Billis and Mahar. Billis getting way up and then coming down with the next rebound.
And Billis, the sophomore out of Rolling Hills, California, has 8 points and 9 rebounds. He only averages 8 points and 5.2 rebounds a ball game. Playing the game of his life, and it couldn't come at a better time.
If you're going to beat a team like North Carolina, you need a couple of guys maybe to play the games of their lives.
They called his game last Saturday against North Carolina the best game of his college career when he had 11 points and 7 rebounds. He's going to better that. Carolina with a chance to take the lead, and once again, Tommy Amaker got a hand in the middle of a fast break and knocked it out of bounds. 15:56 to go in the game. North Carolina trailing the Blue Devils of Duke 45-44. Point halftime lead at 40-32.
Second half shooting, Duke not getting as many opportunities, and their opportunities have not been as good.
Sam Perkins from long range, Dawkins with a long rebound. It's a 2-on-3 break. Yeah, by Henderson, the block to Michael Jordan, and he has the rebound. Ahead to Kenny Smith, and he threw it away.
Great defensive play by both Michael Jordan and Sam Perkins. Mike Krzyzewski thinks that was a foul. Hank Nichols doesn't. Dean Smith, I think, is a little disgusted that Jordan threw that ball away. He knows it's going to be a dogfight all the way down to the end of this game, and that North Carolina can't afford turnovers like that.
Dawkins, Amaker, Henderson, Allery, and Billis in the ballgame right now for Duke. Amaker drives the baseline, fouled by Jordan. Jordan shakes his head.
Good aggressive move by Tommy Amaker. I don't think that Jordan really anticipated that he was going to take that drive. He was looking for him to pass the ball back outside, and he's going to step in position to get it. Amaker recognized, penetrated by. Nice play.
Non-shooting foul, and it was the first foul on Michael Jordan.
North Carolina in the 1-3-1 zone on the out-of-bounds play.
Allery, nice fake, able to penetrate, banks it off the glass. Matt Doherty with the rebound, almost lost it. Now maintains possession. Dumps it off to Kenny Smith.
Real tough shot by Allery. It wasn't on balance. Duke back to the 2-3 zone.
Carolina has not been able to toss an alley-oop up there yet, but it's been successful. There it comes. Sam Perkins with the jam. Every once in a while, I seem to set it up right.
North Carolina setting the tempo for the second half, going right to their big guy inside. Great pass.
Sam Perkins with 9, and Carolina has taken the lead. 46-45. Big possession here for Duke, as Carolina has really made a run at him in the first 5.5 minutes of that half. Amaker's jumper won't go. Billis' offensive tip won't go. The rebound of Perkins. And all at once, Duke's tremendous shooting has gone cold. Get it into Brad Doherty. Leans back. Contact and no whistle. 8 points for Brad Doherty.
What a shot by Brad Doherty. It's amazing that he didn't walk. Mike Krzyzewski thinks he did.
Dawkins from 17 feet. Won't go. Rebound to Perkins.
Duke is really hurting themselves being impatient. They need to get better shots than they're getting.
And they haven't been getting good shots. They've been taking shots that really doesn't seem to be a part of their offense. And as a result, they're down by three with 14 minutes to go in the ballgame.
They were shooting that great percentage in the first half as Doug McNeely gets ready to come back in the game because they were getting excellent opportunities. North Carolina seems to have greatly increased the tempo of the game.
Dawkins is fouled as he passed.
That foul's on Kenny Smith.
And that will be number three on Kenny Smith. So the opposing point guards both have three personal fouls. Billis will sit down for Duke.
North Carolina's pressure has created a helter-skelter tempo that with which North Carolina is much more comfortable than Duke. Duke can play quickly, but they must be under control.
Mallory, that's his shot from the baseline. Won't go, but Henderson with the offensive rebound and buries the jumper. Side saddle from the lane.
Now, Billis has had a great game, and so has Doug McNeely off the bench. He's the guy that tipped that ball out to Henderson. Nice play by McNeely and good bucket by David Henderson.
Right now, Billis is out of there, and Mark Allery is in the middle of the Duke zone defense. And there's Jordan also in the middle.
The Duke zone looks a lot more passive than it did in the first half. The guards in particular are standing, and that might be a product of the fact that they didn't have any rest at all in the first half, and this has been a very quickly paced game.
Allery! He turns after catching the pass so very well and gets Duke back within 1 point. Matt Doherty pulls up to Kenny Smith. Now to Brad Doherty, who thought it was for somebody else and let it go over his head out of bounds. Allery and Jordan are tied for the scoring lead in the ballgame. Both have 14. Kenny Smith goes out. Steve Hale checks back in. And there's the turnover story. Carolina only three in this second half, however. They had 10 in the first half.
They've done a much better job taking care of the basketball, and therefore Duke hasn't gotten the same type of offensive opportunity.
Duke with the ball, a chance to regain the lead. Nice pass to Allery, fouled by Brad Doherty, and that is number four on Brad Doherty. Henderson got a little caught there and just had to get rid of it somehow.
Great catch again by Mark Allery. He's got such, they call it soft hands. The ball sort of settles into them rather than him reaching out and grabbing it. But that was a great catch inside.
And Joe Wolf will come back into the ballgame as Brad Doherty has picked up his fourth personal foul.
Doherty is a little bit foul prone. There's only two North Carolina players all year that have fouled out of a game. Brad Doherty has fouled out five times and Michael Jordan once. So Doherty is prone to foul.
Allery, 77% free throw shooter, got the roll on that one. Allery now with 15 points.
One shot, guys!
His last three ball games, he has averaged almost 25 points and almost 12 rebounds a ball game. He has been on fire. Dawkins, offensive rebound, what a leap by Johnny Dawkins.
And Joe Wolf is 6'11". What a move by Johnny Dawkins, and now a great steal by Amaker.
Amaker stole it, got it to Dawkins, and he couldn't hold on to the ball out of bounds. That could have put Duke up by four.
Some kind of basketball game.
And Duke now showing full court pressure. North Carolina beats it, gets a three-on-three situation, and pulls it back out.
Duke stays in that zone.
Sam Perkins comes up a little short, rebound Matt Doherty. His follow shot is good.
Michael Jordan just came flying through the Duke defenders to tip the ball to Doherty.
52 all, just under 12 minutes left in the game.
Carolina in the 1-3-1 zone.
This has been a beauty. Amaker to Dawkins, cross court, Henderson. Dawkins, nice pass to Allery off to McNeely, who is clumped.
Johnny Dawkins sets up that play by his penetration into the zone. He forces the zone out of position. There he is. He's got two guys on him. Allery's open. When Wolf steps to Allery, the nice pass to McNeely.
Jordan whacked him across the forearm to pick up his second personal foul, so McNeely will get a chance to go to the free throw line.
That's the kind of patience and ball movement that we saw from the Duke Blue Devils the entire first half. They attacked the zone very well on that particular occasion.
McNeely's only points have come from the cherry stripe. He's 2-for-2. 11:39 left in the game. Tied at 52. High arching shot goes right through.
He's really played a heck of a game coming off the bench.
Played well yesterday.
He's a great leaper at 6'5", and you can see by looking at his arms there, he's got a few muscles.
Free throw is good. And Duke regains the lead at 54-52. 11 minutes, 39 seconds left to go in the ballgame. Back at Greensboro after this. To go on this one, Duke on top, 54-52. The top-ranked Tar Heels, 27-1 on the year, have really picked up their shooting percentage in the first half, and you can see how Duke has really gone cold.
North Carolina's done it with defensive pressure. Their defensive pressure against Duke has given them better offensive opportunities and forced the Blue Devils into tougher shots.
Hale and Joe Wolf, along with Doherty. Micheal Jordan and Sam Perkins into the ballgame. Perkins trying to penetrate, has to kick it off to Hale. Misses. Matt Doherty, offensive rebound, follow is good.
Duke switched to the man-to-man defense. North Carolina attacked very effectively.
Matt Doherty with 11 points, and we're tied again at 54.
Doherty used his size advantage against Henderson to get that rebound.
This is McNeely, guarded by Wolf to Henderson. McNeely trying to get the ball to Allery, but Wolf doing a good job of dropping back inside, not letting it happen. McNeely was open low. Amaker did not get him the ball.
Seeing some pretty good man-to-man defense right here.
Dawkins just got by. Hale tries to penetrate, drops it off to McNeely, who walks.
Well, he's trying to drop it off to one of the other McNeely or Allery, who were both cutting along the same path to the basket. They each grabbed the ball, and that's why the walk was called.
We're tied at 54. Carolina with a basketball. Hale to Wolf. Guarded by McNeely to Doherty.
Seen some pretty good defense on the other end as well.
Here's Jordan, left alone from 16 feet, and rims out. Henderson rebound.
Great screen by Joe Wolf to get Jordan open. That was a wide open jumper. He just didn't hit it.
Jay Billis will check back in for Duke. At the first chance, Kenny Smith will come back in for North Carolina. Alley-oop!
My goodness, Mike, I didn't think there was any way that David Henderson could get that ball, but he really took the elevator up to about the 18th floor.
When that thing was in midair, I was thinking the same thing you were. There was no chance he could go that high. But not only did he catch it, he ripped it through in one motion. Perkins' jumper won't go. Matt Doherty keeps it alive and fouled.
Matt Doherty has been doing a super job on the offensive board. That's three times in the last couple minutes that he's gotten an offensive rebound and stuck it back in the basket. Somebody is going to have to block him out.
And he has 13 points, 35 in the last two games, tied at 56. 9:27 left in the ballgame. Henderson guarded by Hale. When you pick up your dribble against these guys, you're in trouble. Doherty with a steal. Showtime!
Mike Krzyzewski's up asking for a timeout. The Blue Devils simply did not move well to the ball. When the dribble's picked up, his players have to come and give somebody an opening.
Micheal Jordan with 16. It's Carolina 58, Duke 56. We'll be back at the Greensboro Coliseum after this. .08 left in the game, 58-56, North Carolina on top. Remember, stay tuned at the end of the game. We'll be picking a player of the game from each school. Look at what's happening in the second half. Duke shooting about 35%. Here's the fast break, the steal of Matt Doherty, ahead to Kenny Smith. Amaker trying to catch it. Sam Perkins took three steps and then jammed it.
I think Sam Perkins was concerned with the presence of Tommy Amaker. He had a great defensive play by Matt Doherty, but Amaker's back. Perkins just caught in between steps there. He should have dribbled the ball one time. Big break for Duke.
The Blue Devils can ill afford to fall farther behind North Carolina, especially since the shot clock will go off in about 4.5 minutes. And if you're behind North Carolina when the shot clock goes off, it's almost impossible to beat them because of their great delay game and their brilliant free throw shooting.
Carolina back to the man-to-man. Sam Perkins matched up against Allery, and that's a real battle.
Allery, the turnaround jumper, and buried it with Perkins in his face. We're tied at 58. Allery has 17 points.
Duke now goes to the man-to-man.
And Kenny Smith goes right by Amaker. Missed the layup. Here comes Dawkins. Look at him explode. Goes by Doherty. Missed the shot. Allery, rebound.
Dawkins did a great job to get that ball up on the board. I think he saw Mark Allery there, and he realized if he could get it on the board, then Allery had a shot at it. Great rebound.
Allery has 19 points, and Duke is back on top, 60-58. Micheal Jordan is fouled.
No!
Sam Perkins called for setting the pick and throwing an elbow, so the basket will not go.
That's a real interesting call. Jay Billis battling his heart out to get over the Sam Perkins pick. And that's why the foul was called the way it was. Now here comes Billis. Perkins has his arm out there. He's holding him. That's a pretty good call.
Allery prevented Jordan from making the jam, but the foul will go against Perkins before the play. And Perkins has three personal fouls, and this will allow Jay Billis to go to the free throw line.
Micheal Jordan on the bench, but you tell me you don't think Sam Perkins is strong. He looks a little thin compared to some of these other guys, but Jay Billis is a big guy, and Perkins simply held him out there on his arm like he was on a clothesline.
Perkins is 231. Wolf comes out of the ballgame as Dean Smith continues to shuffle the power of his lineup. Billis's free throw is good. He'll get another one. Dan Mahar is back in for Duke. Mahar's had a good rest.
Jay Billis was the designated rebounder in the game in the first half. This half it's been Matt Doherty from North Carolina. Doherty's got six rebounds this half.
Billis with 10 points, 10 rebounds.
There's Doherty with another rebound.
Duke leads by three as Billis misses the second free throw. It's 61-58. Duke on top with 7:43 left in the game. Alley-oop to Perkins. And Sam Perkins lost the ball. Billis got it to Dawkins. Perkins just all alone and lost the handle.
Mike, I think he was trying to dribble the ball to get it under control, and that should be a lesson for anybody. First thing you do with the ball is catch it.
Here's the alley-oop to Dawkins, knocked away, but Billis got it back.
And that's an important call because the person that drew that offensive foul was Brad Doherty. And that's one of those things that can go either way. Bad alley-oop pass.
Yes,
Dawkins, I think, had it. There's Billis. Doherty that time was established. That's a pretty good call. As we say, that kind of call can go either way. That's a big break for Carolina because that would have been Brad Doherty's fifth foul.
Plus, it could have put Duke up by 5 points. Right now, they're up 61-58. Smith. Henderson trying to stay with Jordan. Jordan now has the ball, goes right by Henderson to the lane. Missed the shot. Brad Doherty, rebound. No, tip by Jordan. Micheal Jordan in among guys 6-7 inches taller than he is, and he just puts it in.
David Henderson is standing there holding his nose, telling John Falcon that he thought he got fouled.
McNeely had a thought about going to the baseline, pulls it back out. 6:45 left. Duke 61, North Carolina 60. Henderson, they'll call it on Matt Doherty, and that's his first.
What a smooth-looking turnaround jump shot by David Henderson. Nice pass inside. Henderson never had any thought about doing anything but shooting the jumper. Doherty gets called for pushing him with the body. I don't think Doherty's objecting to the foul call. Gee, look at that. 18 fouls for North Carolina, only one for Duke. I don't think Doherty objected to the foul call. I think he was claiming that it happened before Henderson took the shot.
Mike Krzyzewski gets a good look at the scoreboard overhead here at the Greensboro Coliseum. 6:40 to go, Duke by three. Big free throw missed by Henderson. Margin still three. Kenny Smith to Perkins. Matt Doherty. Jordan and Henderson really battling inside. Jordan looking for position to get the ball. Perkins leans into one, missed the shot. Jordan gets it. Micheal Jordan just sails down the free throw line, or down the lane rather, and Mike Krzyzewski wanted him called for a foul on that last possession.
Micheal Jordan is just going after the boards with abandon. McNeely got a hand on Sam Perkins' shot, and Dawkins is the only guy over there. He really is. That's a mismatch inside him going against Brad Doherty and Micheal Jordan. Matt Doherty's ninth rebound of the second half.
It's only one free throw, one personal foul called against Johnny Dawkins in this game. Look at what Doherty has done. And he ties it up right here. 63-63. 6:16 to go. Full court pressure. Henderson to Dawkins. 3-on-2 advantage for North. And Dawkins put it in.
And Michael Jordan just missed getting that. Jordan went into the cheerleaders over there, but boy, was he close.
Dawkins loves to take it all away himself on those fast breaks. Duke by two. We're under 6 minutes to go in the game here, so whistle and a foul.
That is a good aggressive play by Dan Mahar. Brad Doherty trying to go around.
Mike Mahar picks up his second personal foul. And Duke huddling at the free throw line as North Carolina will take the ball out of bounds. Mahar leaving school on April 1st to go work out with the Canadian Olympic team. He's already a member of that club. Jordan, oh, what a quick move to get around Henderson. Skies in the lane, the ball tipped outside. Allery with a rebound to Dawkins, 2-on-2. Jordan trails the play, and Dawkins thinks better of it, comes back outside.
What a great rebound by Mark Allery. He was turning while he was in the air, but he got it and got a good, quick outlet pass.
Amaker tries to get down the lane, cut off, gets it to Dawkins, 17-footer, won't go. Carolina did a great job at blocking out on that one. Kenny Smith. Here's the whistle. Offensive foul on Brad Doherty at the baseline, and he's out of the ball game.
And he's upset about that call. He and Dan Mahar seem to have this thing with one another. Last weekend in Chapel Hill, it was the same way. They were battling and battling inside, and that young man has to be careful. He doesn't want to give Hank Nichols too hard a time.
Maybe we can see it on the lower part of the screen here on the replay.
Kenny Smith penetrating inside. Now there's Doherty getting position inside. Mahar coming around. Yeah, that looks like a pretty good call.
Doherty checks the scoreboard. He has 8 points, 5 rebounds.
Interestingly enough, at the end of the great game these two teams played last weekend, it was just that kind of a foul by Brad Doherty that sent this young man, Dan Mahar, to the free throw line with 9 seconds left in the game. And had Mahar hit that 1-and-1, Duke probably wins that game, but he missed the shot. Carolina's able to tie and win it in overtime. We'll take a look, see how Dan Mahar does in this situation.
Pressure is on again. Duke by two with 5:26 left. You see, he's a 64% shooter, and he made that one. 5 points for Dan Mahar, and a dejected Brad Doherty, the sophomore out of Black Mountain, North Carolina, sitting on the bench beside his teammates. Mahar can give Duke a 4-point lead. And does. Leading scorers in the ballgame, Allery with 19, Jordan and Matt Doherty with 18 apiece. Kenny Smith guarded by Amaker, two sensational freshman point guards. Perkins underneath to Kenny Smith, and he put it home. Got away from Amaker, and Dawkins couldn't get over there fast enough to help out.
Tommy Amaker turned his head, and Kenny Smith went right to the basket. Great play.
The margin is 2, 67-65, 5 minutes even. One, maybe two more possessions with the shot clock on. That's it. Amaker's jumped up from the baseline, won't go. Jordan, rebound.
Excellent defense by North Carolina, Michael Jordan in particular. He didn't give Tommy Amaker a chance to do anything with the ball.
Matt Doherty guarded by Dawkins, gets it to Jordan. Jordan's baseline jumper is good. Michael Jordan with 20, and North Carolina has the lead. Making a tie, 67-67. This is now a game without a shot clock. It is off.
Duke looks like they're going to try to spread the floor. Now this is a dangerous situation for North Carolina because Duke has such great penetrators, particularly this guy with the ball right here. North Carolina can match up with some pretty good quickness, though.
4 minutes, 8 seconds left. Tied at 67. Johnny Dawkins, guarded by Smith, gets the ball to Henderson.
Now, this is a long time to play this kind of a game, and North Carolina would do well to be patient.
Of course, Duke is trying to score. They're not just trying to run out the clock. Henderson, he'll go as far as they'll let him to Amaker, who wants to come back outside. And Carolina will try to trap at every opportunity. Henderson, throw it out of bounds.
We just said that it's a long time to try to play that type of game. North Carolina doing a nice job. No fouls, no unnecessary double teams. Bad break for Duke.
There's a timeout on the court with 3 minutes 42 seconds left to go in the game. Duke 67, North Carolina 67. John Madry, the fact that only three team fouls have been called against Duke, they got a couple to give. They can gamble to go for steal.
North Carolina may be spreading it out as well, and Duke certainly anticipated that with some double-teaming pressure, and David Henderson nearly got the ball.
Almost took it away from Micheal Jordan.
It's a good double-team. Bahar comes over, and Henderson very nearly has the ball. Brad Doherty left his feet, and they almost ended up with nothing to do.
Good anticipation by Henderson. 3:27 to go in the game. We're tied at 6-7.
Duke in the man-to-man. North Carolina appears to be in their regular offense.
Kenny Smith to Perkins. Matt Brad Doherty has already fouled out of the ball.
Was a bad pass. Micheal Jordan had Henderson clearly on his back, but the ball should have been thrown to Jordan's right. Instead, it was thrown to his left hand, and it actually hit David Henderson in the hand.
Under 3 minutes, here's Henderson as Matt Doherty tried to get the charging call. Mallory! Dawkins!
What a tip by Johnny Dawkins! He just went up there and stayed up there until he got the ball.
First, I was so surprised that Allery took a 16-foot jumper, and then Dawkins just soared in from the baseline. Matt Doherty's jumper. Oh, what a clutch basket.
And Doherty has played a clutch game. What a ball game Matt Doherty has played for North Carolina. He's got 9 rebounds in the second half, and that's 20 points.
That's 20 points. He had 22 yesterday. Matt Doherty saw the tournament coming, and he's been tearing it up ever since. We're tied at 69 with 2:18 to go in the game. Mahar, Henderson, cross court to Johnny Dawkins, all alone.
What a big shot by Dawkins. Duke changing strategy a little bit. They weren't trying to hold the ball. Dawkins just buried it.
Matt Doherty's got Perkins low, got him the ball. Perkins jumper.
Excellent defense inside by Mark Allery and by Johnny Dawkins coming down to help him. That was a tough shot, and then Mahar with a big rebound.
Now Duke trying to spread it out. Henderson into the lane, feeds off to Mahar, cross court to Allery. 1:39 to go. Duke leads by 2.
There's still a long time to hold the ball.
Boy, is it ever. Especially against Carolina, as well as they trap.
It looked to me like Joe Wolf was over there trying to foul Mahar.
Dawkins. 1:23 to go. Duke has done this to North Carolina twice. They have come so close, but they haven't beaten them yet. Henderson, baseline, fakes the shot. He's trapped in the corner. Now he drives all the way under and tosses it back up. Gutsy move by Henderson.
Good ball movement. We're down to a minute left in this game.
Trying to kill the clock to get it to Allery when he saw him in that spot.
Carolina running around, trying to put extra defensive pressure. Mark Allery recognized an opening, took advantage of it, and as you say, heads up play by David Henderson to get him the ball. Micheal Jordan came real close to making a big, big defensive play.
Here's the story on Mark Allery. He's had a brilliant ball game, but he's only hit 1 out of 3 from the free throw line, even though he is a 77.5% shooter on this season. 1 minute left, 71-69. Duke by 2. Now 3.
Allery had 2 free throws in last Saturday's game that he had to make. It was a 1-1 to tie the game late in the ball game, and he knocked those in, so he's used to pressure situations.
Well, you know, this young man is clutch. He's been that way all year long. Free throw again is good. A 4-point lead with 1 minute to go. Micheal Jordan, baseline drive. What a great body control, but it won't go. Wolf! Again, it won't go. And he is clobbered by Mark Allery. Joe Wolf just hung in there, and there is Mickey Krzyzewski. That's almost unfair to put a camera on somebody when they're that tight.
North Carolina gave you a clinic in aggressive offensive rebounding. They pounded on the boards. Once that ball came off the first time and North Carolina got their hands on it, Duke really couldn't get in position to block anybody out. Now, these are 2 pretty big free throws for Joe Wolf,
who is, as every Carolina player is, a good free throw shooter at 75.9%.
It's the first time he's had to go to the free throw line in the ACC semifinals down 4.
And he is a freshman with 4 points on the season. No nerves, no nothing, just net.
Ice water.
73-70. Carolina creeps back within three. 51 seconds left. The margin is two, and they're going to get Steve Hale in the ballgame for North Carolina. Wolf will come out, so Dean Smith has a smaller, better defensive team on the court.
Not only does he get a better defensive team on the court, but he gets the game stopped and gets his team an opportunity to set up without calling a timeout.
Mallory will inbound the ball to Johnny Dawkins. Dawkins looks around, finds where all the enemies are, and comes across the timeline. Henderson in the corner. 44 seconds left. The margin is two, and the foul is on Matt Doherty as he went for the steal.
Matt Doherty thought he got close. He's, you see him walking up the sideline. He really thought he had that ball. Almost a big play. As Johnny Dawkins was throwing the ball to Henderson, it went right over the head of Mark Allery.
Right.
And for a minute, Allery started to reach his hands up. I don't think he could have caught the ball, but he very nearly knocked it out of bounds.
And Henderson goes to the free throw line. The sophomore from Drury, North Carolina, 0-for-1 from the line. He is a 73% shooter on the season, has 10 points in the game. It's Duke by two. Make it three, and you see how Henderson reacted. He wanted that one so bad.
We've had Allery, then Wolf, now Henderson in big pressure situations. They haven't even gotten close to hitting the rim.
Henderson's second free throw. Swift. 75-71, Duke by four. Wolf needs to get the ball into somebody, finally, to Kenny Smith. Ahead to Matt Doherty. All the way down the lane, pulls up for the jumper. He has made every big shot he has taken in the last 2 days. Matt Doherty has really put on a show, and you got to be happy for that young man who has been satisfied to be a role player his entire career at North Carolina. Everybody likes to get a little of the glory. In the last 2 days, he's gotten his share. Krzyzewski, he has two timeouts left, as does Dean Smith. Duke still has two fouls to give, incidentally, if it should be a factor.
Mark Allery, very smart play. North Carolina set it up so that Duke could not get the ball inbounds. Excellent defense. Allery took a look, recognized, called the timeout. Now that eliminates a timeout, but it's still a good play by Allery. You don't want to turn it over in that situation, or worse, make a bad pass inbounds and give North Carolina an easy opportunity.
Dan, let me ask you this. In the two games that Duke played against North Carolina, they could have won both of them. I know some of the people in the Duke program feel they should have won both of them. Now you're in a situation with 35 seconds left. Do the Duke players start wondering, what's going to happen now?
The Duke players don't care. They know there's 35 seconds left in the game and they can win the ball game. They're not thinking about what happened before.
Duke and Carolina fans have both had a lot to cheer about today. Their teams have played very, very well. And everybody, for certain, will go home hoarse, if nothing else.
Well, let's see what Duke has done to try to get this ball inbounds. North Carolina really has a knack for stealing the inbounds pass.
Henderson gets the ball to Allery. 31 seconds left to go. Dawkins has got to beat that 10-second line. Does to Allery. 24 seconds left. Cross-court pass to Dawkins.
They should keep the ball moving.
Amaker into the corner. Allery is all alone underneath, but he's fouled Henderson, and I don't think Sam Perkins knew what a great foul it may have been.
I don't know whether he knew it or not. It certainly was a great one. Mark Allery was real close to being in that lane 3 seconds. Here you can see, there's the pass over. Now Allery steps in the lane. He's standing there. There's the foul right there. That's pretty close to a 3-second call.
Of course, the slow motion makes it a little deceptive on the replay,
makes it
too.
He's in there longer. That's right. It's a tough game for the officials, too. They know what's at stake here. They've done an outstanding job.
Henderson, 2 out of 3 from the line. 17 seconds left to go in the game. This is the biggest shot of his career, and he made it. 76-73, Duke by 3 with 17 seconds left. Big shot here. It could mean that North Carolina would need 2 possessions to tie it up.
North Carolina still has plenty of time, Mike.
77-73. Matt Doherty, Mahar reached in, went for the steal, committed the foul, and what this did more than anything else was stop the clock at 15 seconds.
Mike Krzyzewski certainly did not want that. He told his players to get up and put some defensive pressure. The thing is, though, it's not a one and one. And so that's five fouls now. They still have one more to give before North Carolina goes to the line. So maybe that's not such a bad, I don't think Mike Krzyzewski wanted it, but it's not such a bad foul.
And how many times over the years have you seen the situation reversed where North Carolina was the team that had the fouls to give? Kenny Smith trying to inbound. They get it into Jordan. I'd file him right there, and that's what Johnny Dawkins did.
Okay, now that's it for Duke. They don't have that option anymore, but they ran 4 seconds off the clock with those fouls. North Carolina took them 4 seconds to get the ball up the court.
So there's 13 seconds left. Duke is down 77-70, or Duke is ahead 77-73. North Carolina needs a basket desperately, and they need it in a hurry. Wolf to Kenny Smith. Smith with 10 seconds, pistol shot, pull, fires. Jordan and Jordan scores. 5 seconds on the clock as Michael Jordan has just scored his 21st and 22nd point. Duke with a 2-point lead, and virtually all they have to do is get it inbounds to a player in a white jersey.
A player in a white jersey who is going to have to go down and make a free throw, Mike, to sew the thing up, because North Carolina does have a timeout left. If Duke gets the ball inbounds and Carolina gets a foul right away, then if Duke misses the free throw, Carolina gets a timeout. They're going to have 3, possibly 4 seconds to get the final shot of the game. So first, the inbounds pass is important, but I think somebody from Duke is going to have to knock one home to sew this thing up.
And you have to imagine that Carolina's strategy is going to be, if Duke does get the inbounds pass, you have to foul immediately, because even if one tick goes off the clock, it only leaves you 4 seconds, and you still need the basket to tie.
I think we'll see Mike Krzyzewski possibly get Dan Mahar out of the game and get somebody, a better free throw shooter, in. Now, maybe not, because it's possible that Mahar might inbound the ball, and so there wouldn't be the opportunity to foul him.
It's a shame we couldn't have had a better game for you this afternoon. A two-pointer with 16th-ranked Duke leading North Carolina, the number one team in the nation, 77-75 with 5 seconds left. And we want to thank the crew that has worked on this ACC tournament. We feel we have the best technicians, the best camera people, just the best bunch of folks working in the business. And we thank them for a tremendous job. Henderson followed by Doherty, and it'll be a 1-1.
Good job by David Henderson. He went after that ball like his life depended on it. He got the ball. Doherty coming over the back for the foul. Now there's 4 seconds left. That play took 1 second. Henderson, if he makes the first free throw, the ball game's over. But if he misses the first free throw, Carolina, with one timeout left, can still get the ball and call the timeout and still have as much as 3 seconds to get down the court and get a shot. So this one isn't over yet, and this is a big free throw for David Henderson.
Well, he's hit 4 clutch ones here late in the second half.
Now, Dean Smith wants to save his last timeout, but he's going to put in some substitutes here. And if the effect is going to be the same as a timeout, because he's going to make David Henderson wait. Now, well, Henderson's trying to stay away from the line, but let's see if Dean Smith gets him in the game. No, he's not going to.
Dean Smith will drag it out just as long as he can. He'll use every tool in the book. Henderson makes the free throw. Carolina uses its last timeout. With 3 seconds left, they are still alive. And for Duke, looking at North Carolina, they must look at the Tar Heels as a cat. These people have 9 lives, and you just can't put them away.
It's deja vu for the Duke Blue Devils. As we said earlier, last Saturday in Chapel Hill, Duke had almost the same opportunity. There was just more time left in the game. With 9 seconds, Mahar missed the front end of a 1-1 that could have put the game away. Now, North Carolina has no timeouts left. Duke has been in 4 overtime games out of their last 6 contests, so it wouldn't be anything new for them. North Carolina is going to get the ball out of bounds, almost underneath their own basket. They may take it out under the basket. It depends on where the referee ruled the timeout was called, or they might have it up to the area of the foul line extended. So they're going to have to go at least 75 feet in 3 seconds to score.
Which means either you're going to take a chance on a 60-footer, or you're going to have to throw a long pass down court and take your chances on that.
Well, if you're Duke, there's one thing you have to be sure of, and that's that something in this play involves Michael Jordan. You know, it might not be a bad play just to throw the ball up in the air at about the top of the key and have him go get it.
And Mike Krzyzewski, I'm sure, is telling his club, heaven's sakes, if you foul, make sure he doesn't make the basket. 77-75. Duke on top by two. The Blue Devils led 40-32 at the half. Carolina made one of those great runs at him, tied it up, but give Duke a lot of credit. They bowed their back, they hung in there, and right now they have a two-point lead with 3 seconds left.
Now, Duke does not want to foul, obviously. North Carolina's in the one-and-one, but Duke needs to play good defense. They don't want North Carolina to be able to throw a long pass down the court. They want North Carolina, you can see they've got about 75 feet to go. Doherty's at the free throw line extended. They want to force them to throw the ball inbounds in the backcourt and have them take a couple of dribbles. Let's see what happens. Now, all teams have plays for situations like this.
3 seconds left. Got to get it in. And it's out of bounds. They tried to hit Micheal Jordan at the sideline, and the pass from Matt Doherty was too wide. It went out of bounds with 2 seconds left.
Now, Mike Krzyzewski's considering calling his last timeout. He's making sure he's got one before he calls one.
What he's also finding out now is where he gets the ball. Does he get it where Duke or where North Carolina threw it or where it went out of bounds?
Well, maybe he's finding out if he actually gets the ball. Okay, now Duke is saying
he gets the ball.
Duke's saying that they have the ball, but I think Dean Smith was saying that one of the Duke players hit it out of bounds. All right, let's take a look and see what happens. Now, Jordan, you just saw him leave the screen. They're going to try to get the ball to him in the corner. Pass going down just too far. Jordan touched it, I think, when it was inbounds, and that's why the 1 second is ticked off the clock. The clock actually ran down to zero. We'll see how much time they put
back. And if he did touch it while it was inbounds, then Duke will get possession where the ball went out of bounds. If he did not touch it when it was inbounds, then where Matt Doherty threw it in is where Duke will take possession, and that's what they're doing.
All right, now if that's the case, then there's still 3 seconds left on
that's
the
right.
clock. You can't run any time off the clock if the ball never hit somebody inbounds.
Exactly.
It looked like that the ball went down and hit a water cooler down there before Jordan got it.
It hit something or someone before it got to Michael Jordan. Now, Duke, all they have to do is get the ball in, and we're still working the clock back down as Johnny Dawkins checks with Mike Krzyzewski. Let's see how far they bring it back down, if indeed they do go to 3 seconds.
Now, Mike Krzyzewski is over there telling Mark Allery, and Allery's right in front of the Duke bench. You can see Mike Krzyzewski there. If Allery gets in any kind of trouble at all, he's going to call a timeout. Duke still has the one left. Krzyzewski went to the scorer's table to check that out.
And there are 3 seconds left on the clock. Allery will be the trigger man.
Hank Nichols is moving people around over there. Give Allery enough room to throw it inbound.
Allery to Dawkins, followed by Hale. 2 seconds left. That took one, but Johnny Dawkins can ice it. Let's see if it's a one-and-one. It is a one-and-one called by Joe Forte.
Now, this game is not over yet. There's still 2 ticks of the clock. Dawkins is really going to have to make the free throw.
Let's see who comes into the ballgame for Carolina. David Popson will come in.
Well, now, what Dean Smith has done, he's got all his tall people in the game. Popson, Wolf, Perkins, Doherty, and Michael Jordan on a miss. Either Perkins or Wolf, whoever gets the rebound, is just going to throw it up down the court. Hope for the foul or hope for the alley-oop play.
Dawkins, 2 for 2, 16 points. This shot could ice it. And he missed it. Perkins, 95.
One happy group of Duke Blue Devils. What a basketball game they played.
These teams this year played 3 tremendous games, battled each other down to the wire in all 3 of them. And this time, the Blue Devils of Duke have pulled out a victory over North Carolina. An absolutely incredible basketball game. The 16th ranked Blue Devils have upset the number 1 Tar Heels.